Good morning, fans of Privateer FX. Tough day yesterday. Had to take a little break there. But we're back in the saddle today. Some pretty startling price action overnight. Euro has popped up 100 points, 116.66 the high. Dollar basically has turned basically risk on, I guess, with the positive results from the Eurozone meetings. The market has taken this as quite positive for the Euro. Leaves us in a bit of a conundrum here today. So we've got half year fixed today, 5 p.m. We've got European CPI at 11. And the charts now, as you can see on the Euro, and this kind of sums it up for all the dollar-based charts, we're right in the middle now. So this doesn't get interesting for us until we get above 117 and a quarter. We're back below 115 and a quarter. So we're just going to sit and watch Euro for a little bit. Cable, you could argue that if this dollar trend keeps going down, the market's going to be short cable. This might be interesting. We're still a little jaded from yesterday, in which we had a whole lot of money on the table in that first hour, and we pressed it, and the day ended up being a scratch, which is shameful, but we've got to live with it. This is lagging here. Obviously, the bad news about London, the bad news about Brexit could be holding this back. But the market is going to be short cable. So, I don't know. We're not going to be trading this, but through 130-130 might get a little twitchy for any stale shorts from yesterday who survived the move up to 28. Dollar yen ripping higher with this risk on sentiment. 110.90 is the range highs. Tough to break trade 110.90 because you're going into 111 the figure. And now we've had this pretty steady diet of up days here. One would think it might run out of steam. So we're kind of leaving this alone. We're keeping an eye to see if we get a 110.90 print. Plus the fix, based on some of the stuff we've read, is going to be a dollar sell today. So, but mild dollar sell. Euro yen shot up on this positive euro sentiment. Could argue that this is probably a buy on dip now today, but again, we're going to be patient. We're going to wait for something five star, which is the normal operating procedure after an emotionally difficult day. You just have to sit back and wait and be patient. Always another trade. Aussie yen, catching a lot of people short. Wow. This will be interesting if we can get a print up at 81.94. And if this thing does go risk on somehow and the world turns rosy again, Aussie yen is going to rip. Because this is the consensus short for China blowing up. So keep an eye on the yuan. Keep an eye on China. Aussie yen. Sterling yen printed a turn bar. It's already jammed higher, so you're a bit late to the game, but again, just watching. This is a trend line that people have drawn. Let's see where this thing goes. Pretty far still. Should be resistance first time there. 146.23, 100 points away. In general, we're just watching. Frustrated with yesterday's trade. And also very, very weary of month-end fix. We'll probably get involved with European CPI if it's a big outlier. It rarely is. But if it is, we'll be looking both ways and try and trade the number. Quick look at equities. Man, we were conviction short at 05 yesterday and looked good there for about an hour. Down to 94. Here we are again. 27.29. New high today. In the middle of this, now heading into the middle of this overall range, 2800, 2693. Nothing to do there, so just hold steady, see where we go. One last thing, Bitcoin edging towards 5200, which will be a buy zone, as will 4200. Those of you who are using Gemini to trade in New York hours, you just gotta hope for the best. Obviously you won't be trading over the weekend, but same strategy still applies. We're buying dips at 52 and at 42, and then we'll be looking to sell most of that out at a 10 or 20% premium, and then holding a core 10%. All right, I've said enough for today. I will leave it to you guys and check in with you along the way. Cheers.